and welcome to Vinny's Edo World. Looking at the thumbnail, you would have got an idea. Today's video is about what? It's about the bomb that CBSE has dropped over grade 10th and grade 12th kids. Day before yesterday, CBSE rolled out a circular regarding the change in exam pattern. So we will be discussing that in detail. As we all know, Corona has changed our life throughout. We all are stuck at home. We are not able to go out. We are not able to go to work. We are not able to go to schools, right? So with that, last year exams were cancelled. Kids were very happy. So what CBSE thought, I can't keep the kids happy always. Let me just give some twist to their life, and they changed the pattern of the exam altogether. So now what's happening is the exam is divided into two parts. Till now we used to write one final exam, right? Now going forward, it's going to be in two parts. But it's not very new. Earlier also, I think couple of years back, 3-4 years back, there was a pattern of essay 1 and essay 2. Similar kind of pattern. Okay, so let's discuss the details. Okay. So as I said, till now you had one board exam in the month of March, April, right? Now for this year, CBSE has announced that you will have two exams. One is term 1 and another one will be term 2, midterm or end of the term. You can address it like that. So the term 1 will happen in November, December. And term 2, regular time, March to April. So for term 1, how much time is left? Already we are in July, August, September, October, November. 5th month, we have the exam. So remember, this exam is board exam. You have two boards now. Term 1 will also be conducted by CBSE board. Question paper will come from CBSE. Marks will be given by CBSE. It will not be given by the school as the midterm exam. Everything will be decided by CBSE. It is your proper board exam which is happening in the middle of the year, that is by November. Okay, and other thing, it will be half of the syllabus. Term 1 will consist of 50% of the whole syllabus. Now, whole syllabus means what? In the circular, they have clearly mentioned that 50% of the rationalized syllabus. Now, what is rationalized? Rationalized is reduced syllabus. CBSE has not given the reduced syllabus as of now. They will give that by the end of July. Okay, so of this reduced syllabus, 50% will come in term 1 and the rest of the 50% will come in term 2. So whatever you read, you study in term 1, you don't have to go ahead and do that in term 2 again. Clear? Okay. Now for term 1, your question paper will be for 90 minutes. 90 minutes. Okay. So how much is it? 1.5 hours. It is not like our regular 3 hours long question paper. No, it is 1.5 hours, 90 minutes question paper. And also the whole thing will be MCQ. You will have only MCQ question answers and you will be answering in a OMR sheet. OMR sheet where you will be coloring the correct option. You don't have to solve it. You don't have to show how you got the value. You just have to color the correct option and send, upload it. Okay. And the big thing about OMR sheet is the sheets, your answer sheets will be uploaded to CBSE portal on the same day itself. Evaluation is very easy. So maybe you will get the result also same day. Who knows? Okay. So that is about term 1. Term 2. Term 2 is when it will happen in March, April 2022. Here again, 50% syllabus will be coming. Whatever you did in term 1 will not be included. Term 2, whatever is left of the whole syllabus, 50% will come in term 2. And here the question paper will be for 2 hours. And it will be a subjective question paper. Subjective means your open-ended, your close-ended, all your long question answers, short question answers, everything will be included, and your regular subjective question paper will be provided for term 2. Okay? Now, again, CBSE has given you different situations which can happen. You know, Corona is there. You never know what will happen. So they have provided us with 4 different situations. First one is the most desirable situation. We all want to go to school. We all want Corona to say goodbye to us and leave us, right? But that is all our thoughts, isn't it? We all wish that. So this is the most desirable situation where you go to school and write your exams. Term 1 and term 2, you go to school, you write the exam at the school or the center provided to you. Right? So if that is the scenario, what will happen? Your mark will be equally distributed. Weightage will be equally distributed. 50% from here, 50% from there. That is the best. Everybody is happy with that. Right? But now what happened? CBSE said there is one more situation. What is it? Term 1, Corona is not giving you any relief. You know, you are not able to go out of your house. You are still locked inside your house. And term 2 situation is under control. If that is the scenario, term 1, where will be you writing the exam? From your home, offline mode, online mode, you will be writing the exam from your home. And term 2, you will be going to the school or your respective centers and write the exam, right? So here what will happen? Logically, more weightage will be given to term 2 and less weightage will be given to term 1. Right? Clear? Okay. Again, there is one more situation. What if a situation is okay in November and situation is not good in April? What will happen? November, you're very fine, you're happy, you go to school, you write your exam, everything done. But again, the situation worsens, you are locked at home. So term 2 you will be writing from home, but now you won't have the subjective paper. If you are writing term 2 from home, you won't get your subjective paper. You will again get a 90 minute MCQ paper only. Okay, but here which exam will get more weightage? The one which you wrote from school will get more weightage. Okay. Now, worst case scenario, what? Corona does not leave at all. It is here. Then what will happen? Both your exams will be conducted from home, online or offline mode. Right? So, what can happen? By your luck, maybe both the exams, everybody is scoring really well. But CBSE is not that fool. What will CBSE do? CBSE will say, we will have to do a proper data analysis. They will give your result based on all your internal, all your practical, all your project work and the marks that you have attained in the examination. Okay, so in a whole, what should we understand? We have to study throughout the year. Okay, all our unit tests, our periodic tests, our assignments, internals, projects, practicals, everything is very, very important. Don't take anything lightly. Till now, what used to happen? We used to say, till pre-board, we will just go like that. After pre-board, we will study really well. Maybe by January, February, kids used to start their preparation. But now that is not going to work. Okay, because we never know what is the situation. If you don't get chance to go to school and write any one of those exams, all our internals, practicals, class test, unit test, everything will be taken into account. So we have to make sure that we need to study really well. Okay, that is one thing. Are you worried? Are you tensed? No need. See, till now also you used to study very well. So what should you keep in mind? NCERT book is our Bible. 90% questions will come from your NCERT book only. So first and foremost, go ahead and mug up your NCERT book. Not mugging up, learn your NCERT book. Try to get all the concepts clear, because all the questions will be coming from NCERT book itself. Okay, don't think like, you know, MCQ questions are coming, so I should go ahead and buy this sample paper, that sample paper, MCQ books. No need. Please don't do that. First and foremost, give importance to your NCERT book. Learn each and every concept clearly. Get the concepts correct. For maths, otherwise also, we go through each and everything, isn't it? All the exercise kids do. And only, so in maths, I don't think anything big changes is there. But for other subjects, yeah, you will have to go through the chapter line by line. So, if you go practicing right now itself, I don't think it's a big problem. There is a plus point that you don't have to prepare the whole thing at one time. You have to go half and half, 50%, 50%. And the next good thing is syllabus is also going to be reduced. Okay, so don't worry, chill, relax, and start your preparation in a systematic way now itself. Okay. Have a nice day, guys. Prepare very well. If you like this video, please do subscribe, like, and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.